onwards, we are starting our computer syllabus of 8th class. Our first chapter is Introduction to MS Access 2010. First of all, I will explain you ki what is MS Access. See, MS Access is a database management system. Then question will arise, what is database management system? So first of all, I will explain you introduction of DBMS. See, DBMS stands for Database Management System. Now, what is data? Data is a raw fraction figure. Raw fraction figures means any kind of information, not information. Data can be anything. If we are talking about information, information is a different thing and data is a different thing. If you are searching in the internet, there are so many data available on internet. If you are doing shopping or you are any kind of shopping website, they are having the data. So data is the most important thing nowadays in the internet or any purpose. So if we are talking about any organization, any institute, so data is like information, not exactly the information. Data can be anything. Next term is database. Now what is database? Database is a collection of related data. See, now what is related data? Data should be connected with each other. If you are talking about the let us take the example of university. See, university has a vast amount of data. If we are finding out the website of university, they are having every kind of data. But if you want to search the faculty of university, they are having the different column over there. If you are finding the courses of university, they are having the different column. But data should be related. If you are talking about database, so data is a different thing. But if we are talking about the database, so data should be related with each other. That is called database. Now next term is database management. Database management, if I want to create a database list of my 10 friends, so if there is some criteria of 10 friends, 20 friends, so easily you can maintain in Blackboard your friends number, contact number and names. If you are saying like, we have to create 100 friends data, it will easily create it in the diary. But if you are talking about the 1000 friends data, so you have to maintain the database. Now the question will arise that, ki ma'am, we can create in computer files. Yes, we can create in computer files also in data. But every like Word file, Excel file, there is a limit of Excel file and Word file. Okay, question will arise, ki ma'am, we can create so many data in Excel. Exactly, we can create. But in that case, we have to maintain individual and different file in Excel. But if you are creating the database management system, there is no constraint. We can create database with the constraint. Now next term is database management system. What is system? System is exactly MS Access 2010. See, MS Access 2010 is nothing but it is a version of MS Access. There are so many versions are available nowadays. We can use any of the version. So system is providing an interface, providing a platform to use database management system. The next term is why we need DBMS. See, before DBMS, we are maintaining the data in a way of traditional way, which is in files, which is in diaries, in the copies. We are maintaining data like that only. But after we are getting the software of DBMS, it is very easy for us if we maintain data in a DBMS system. If the stranger will come and he or she will ask about some kind of data, or if we want to hide some kind of column like contact number or personal address, we can hide this information also. So that is why we are using DBMS. Now the next term is advantages of DBMS. Obviously, there is so many advantages of DBMS. That is why we are using nowadays DBMS. The first is data consistency. What is data consistency? Data consistency means there is a sequence, there is a relation between data. That is called data consistency. The next advantage is data redundancy. Data redundancy or data duplication. See, what is the duplication? If we are taking the example of a class. If in the class there are two or three students there who are having the same names, we can differentiate their names with the contact number, or we can put some constraint or condition over there, so we can easily differentiate these students with the same name. So this is called redundancy. We can remove redundancy or duplication in our data. The next advantage is that data secured. See, if you are maintaining the database management system, so we can secure with the password, we can secure our data with the constraint. What is constraint? Constraint is nothing but the condition. We can put so many conditions over there. So, if you are maintaining the database management system, our data will be secure data. Now, next up is uses of DBMS. We can create the DBMS of data. We can again, if we are creating one file, we can again store next file in only one DBMS. Before we can create again and again new file, we can add new data in that particular DBMS. We can modify it. We can easily we can fire the query and we can easily modify our data. And if we want to find out the some kind of data, we can fire the query and we can easily find out the data. The next is update. If we put the wrong data or if I have any confusion in the data, we can easily update the data with the help of query. Here we have completed our this topic. You have to revise it again and again at your home. You have to stay at home and stay safe.